Rawhide. Hello again, folks. Welcome to another edition of Between the Banks. I'm Bob Googe. And looks like the fish are greeting us first thing in the morning with a nice keeper spikle trout. There you go. Now, folks, I have a gaggle of guests on board. Take this fish off. When we come back, I'm going to introduce who my victims or victors are. We're going to find out. Stay tuned. It's another Rock'em Sock'em edition of Between the Banks. Stick with us. It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood. Between the Banks is brought to you by Blue Cross and Blue Shield of Louisiana.
What does it mean to be a Louisiana company? It means we all work where we live. It means the people we call our customers, we also call our neighbors, our friends, our family. It means we'll be here for the same people who've been here for us. We're the employees of Blue Cross, Louisiana true since 1934.
And down to Bayou. That's how we tell you to get from one place to the other. It's a little different, but so are we in Louisiana's Cajun Bayou. And once you get here, you'll understand why our Cajun runs a little deeper. Find a piece of our story on swamp tours, fishing boats, at festivals, attractions, and restaurants. Visit lacajunbayou.com to plan your trip today. Louisiana's Cajun Bayou. Rich, natural, unapologetically Cajun. Just south of New Orleans, where Cajun runs deep.
Folks, everybody gets Between the Banks. Here's how easy it is. Go to your address bar, type in betweenthebanks.com. Search, and here you are. The latest videos, services, and products provided by Between the Banks. Check it out, betweenthebanks.com. Everybody gets Between the Banks.
Oh, no, he's still there.
Okay. Oh, catfish. All right. We're going to flip that fish off, folks. Now, I got to tell you the truth. Connie caught a catfish, too. But we spit it right at the boat. We're in the cats, but we're not in the bite time. But let me introduce who I have on the boat. I've got Wayne LaBeouf. Now, you know with last name LaBeouf, you know they know how to fish. I mean, it just comes natural Cajun name like that. And then he also, lead that right there, Wayne. He also brought his wife, Connie. Connie, come off the deck. Let me introduce you to her. Here she goes. Connie LaBeouf here, Wayne's wife. She's out on the boat with us also. Now I'm gonna tell you how they got a trip out here later on as we do some more fishing. Stay tuned. Now you know who? Let's see what you got. I think you got a spat. Check them out on the water here, folks. See what this is. Running like a trout. Running like a nice trout. Coming around the side of the boat to see what it is. Alright, hold our rod tip up. Good fish, whatever it is. If it's a speck, it's a nice one. Good rod tip up. Can't tell. What we got here? Let's back up here. Alright, hang on a sec. Go ahead. Oh, big catfish, good living right there, man. Oh, you got him foul hooked too inside of the mouth. All right, folks, we're laboring through the catfish. Stay tuned. Bite's not on, no reason to leave. Stick with us. We'll take him off. All right, got another one on. We're gonna see what this is. Gonna see what this fish is. Take your time. You're going to have to get on the other side of the boat. Connie, you go up to the front deck. There you go. Coming up right here alongside the boat. Looks like he's up on top right here. Check him out on the water. Oh yeah, big splash, big splash. All right, nice fish. That's what I'm looking for, folks, horses like that. Now, Connie had one on earlier. Now, Wayne's gonna have one. Nice bait. Check it out. All right, Wayne.
All right.
Good job, bro. You can see those big cockahoes. You don't catch small ones, catch nothing but big ones. Goo-goos, big cockahoes come through again. Stay tuned. Smaller one, male. Can hear him croaking. That's definitely a sign of a male. All right, husband and wife, staying pretty even. Oh yeah, that one in here a bit. But the males are the smaller of the species. So, and you can tell them, put your hand there, you can feel them croaking. So you know they're a male. But you always want to check them to make sure that they're 12 inches. And that one's almost 13. Don't forget, speckled trout, you can have 25. Gotta be at least 12 inches. If they're close, throw them back, because when you throw them in the ice box, their backbones compress. And if he just made 12 inches, he'll be short then. One other trick I can show you. A fish is always longer on one side than the other. So here you can see the fish is 12 and a half or so. If I roll the fish over, now the fish is almost 13 inches. So if ever you come up short, a fish is always longer on one side than the other side. See, there's all kind of things I'm gonna teach you today, folks. Stay tuned.
Oh, nice back. Bringing him up to the net.
Excellent job. Fish are turning on more and more. Just gotta be patient, folks. Just gotta be patient. If you're patient and you wait for the bite, and you know when the bite's coming, you can save yourself a lot of gas. Another nice fish. Connie walking the dog, hammering the fish. Stay tuned. Connie's on him again. Looks like a speck. Looks like he got a speck. Looks like he broke the surface. Another speck. Yep, sure is. Good job, huh? Good job. Now I'm gonna tell you, folks. Wayne told me that Connie was gonna shellack him. He says it happens all the time. Well, scent of a woman, folks. Scent of a woman. You know, always gets the fish on. And look, she's driving the hook right into the fish's mouth. See where she's hooking them at? Right at the top of the mouth? That tells me she's setting the hook. She knows what she's doing. Another nice keeper for Connie. All right, looks like the fish are turning on. Stay tuned. I'm going to show you how I got them rigged. And just next fish. Stick with me. All right, Connie hooked up again. Keep reeling them, Connie. Got you a nice fish here. Ooh, big speck, Connie. Big speck. Big speck. You can see him over there on the water coming towards us. Check her out, reeling in that line. There you go. Keep reeling in. He's coming around the front. Just keep him coming. Got him under the boat. Keep him coming. There he is, right here on the side. Five face rods him up. Ooh, monster speck. Monster speck. Monster speck. All right, listen to me real good. Okay, raise your rod him up. Bring it to him. Got him in the net. Now there's a big speckled trout. Come on over here, Connie. Face the camera. Now here's a big speckled trout, folks. Check it out. Look at this horse. Look at this big monster. Check this out. Now that's a really big speck. All right, hand me your rod. All right, there's Lunker. And there's the angler with her fish. Now how much does it weigh? Probably 5+. Let's put it on the Boga grip and check it out. Alright, so looking at the Boga grip, we're right at 4 pounds. Nice fish here. Nice fish. Check out the belly. Big female, full of eggs. Is that the biggest fish you ever caught in your life as far as speck goes?
Yep. As far as speck.
There you go, bruh. It's moments like this that turn a captain on when their crew catches the biggest fish of their life. So, I bet you all are glad y'all been on that trip.
Oh, huh? Yeah.
All right, folks, stay tuned. The big ones are on. The bite is right around the corner. You know how I was preaching about the bite, Connie? Look, 8:25, you caught that fish, and it's not bite isn't going to start till 9:30. But really, an excellent fish. Excellent fish. Really good job. You are walking the dog. You're going to be an official member of the Between the Banks fishing team. I can tell you that. All right, stay tuned, folks. Are you jealous, Wayne?
Yes.
Stick with us. All right, folks, this is how I've got the anglers rigged up. I've got them on a team dial, a 7-foot medium action rod. I got them fishing with Revo 3000H. It's a 3000 class reel instead of a 4000 like everybody uses. I can still put 125 yards on it, and it's lighter weight. Very comfortable for the angler. I've got 12-pound test Berkeley Pro Spec. 12-pound test, diameter of 10. So I can put 125 yards on that spool and have plenty enough line. Then at line's end, it's the standard Carolina rig that I use. I come to a black crane swivel. Then I come to 1/8 ounce weight. I'm on a 30-pound test shock leader to a 1/0 kale hook with a cockahoe. Huge cockahoe. Look at the size of that cockahoe. And that's why we're catching big fish. Big bait, big fish. On the leader, that 1/8 ounce weight, I pass line through it once, then twice. And I do that because in case I want to... Oh, the birds are on. Everything. Life is good here. I hear y'all. Y'all can't get on TV unless you speak English, so get away. But look, I can pull that weight down, and I can come. And now I've got a cork rig. All I got to do is click on that Comel cork. So either way, whether I'm Carolina rigged or corked, I can use the same leader without having to switch lines. Okay? So that's how I've got them rigged. You can get all of this gear over at Tides. Tides, great croissants, great food, complete tackle store right here in Meville. Now what the anglers are doing is they're casting out. Okay, I got the wind coming at our back. I'm casting into the trench at Philo. We're holding our rod tips up and we're just keeping them tight. The other boats are running around. We're still fishing, all right? And that's all we're doing here is just keeping a tight line on them, letting that weight sit on the bottom, letting the minnows swim all around above that weight. And sooner or later, the big females can't stand it anymore. They'll come up and eat that bait. So that's what we're doing. That's how we're rigged. Go check out the gang at Tides. Tell them Cap Bob sent you. If you're looking for this rig, you can buy it at Tides for $150. Between the Bank special. That's rod, reel, and line. Go into Tides, tell them you want the Between the Bank special, and they'll fix you up. All right, so that's how we're doing it. You know who, you know how, you know why. The trench, that's why the fish are here. we're just sitting here patiently waiting for the bite to start, which is 20 minutes away.
Ha! Take your time, Tommy. Enjoy the moment. Keeping time.
So we know that that's probably a trout. Look at him on the side of the boat. It is a spank. Going over towards the net. God, he's very good. Very good. Little male. But box. Every fish so far, folks, been a keeper. There's a little male croaking away. Croaking away. Alright, in the box it goes. Getting back out there again. We're in the bite. Stay tuned.
Connie on them again, and it's another big one, Connie, so take your time. Got you another big one on.
Now, she's had big specks on the whole time. She missed one about 5-6 pounds. Put a 4 in, caught a 3. She's on them. Here it is, right alongside. Check it out. Nice fish. Oh, yeah. All right. All right. I'm staying right here, buddy. There you go. Awesome fish. Another big fish, Tom. Another real nice one. Boy, that little modified hook was sweet, ain't
yeah.
it? You don't have to set the hook or anything. What I did, folks, was I put Connie on the live bait hook. See? Compared to a kale hook, see how small that hook is? And it works good on not having to really set the hook or see that it's still alive. I got a little light that I'm going to change him. Another fish for Connie. That's right. Wayne didn't leave. He's still on the boat. Connie's just putting it on her husband, that's all. The scent of a woman, I can tell you. Oh, yeah, the scent of a woman. All right, so, folks, here's a little something that you can do. We got a brisk wind. We're fishing down current and everything, but sometimes it's hard to tell whether the fish is on or not, especially a big speck. So what I do is I do the same rig, but at the end, I'm gonna use a live bait hook or a circle hook. So that way when the fish eats the bait, he's gonna hook himself. No hook set needed. He's gonna pull the line and you'll know he's there. Just to give the anglers an edge by switching hook. All right, I know I use a one-odd kale hook all the time, but there's a small live bait hook or a small circle hook sometimes can get you through when the fish are having you're having a hard time feeling them hit, where they're just mouthing the bait and then walking off with it. So that's what we're doing now. We're in the bite, but it's still tough fishing. Now, my partners that are charter captains down below me, they're fishing Fouchon and all that area. So they've got 3 boats out with 4 people in each boat, and they don't have a one keeper fish. This time of year, the reason you're catching sharks now, water temperature is way up, and you also have the dead zone, which is caused by the water coming out of the Mississippi River full of nitrogen, all the fertilizers, the runoff comes out into the Gulf and depletes the oxygen. So this time of year, I'm nowhere near the coast. I'm not at Castet. I'm not at all the islands near Timbalea or any of that because of the dead zone. So I'm always working north, and sometimes I'll try a hook like that just to get the specks in the boat. Stay tuned. May it come off there, Connie. Keep on reeling though, just in case it's fire. Let it go. That's all right. It's a false start. go ahead and wing it back out there.
Oh, you got some of
it. No, I'm hooked on the bottom. Alright, folks. Let's take a break here while I got my anglers out. We'll go to the marine a minute. All the fine businessmen in Lafourche Parish that make your fishing trip complete. Starts at the north end of the parish. Got Kramer, Lake des Almonds. Then you come a little bit further south. You got Terrio Launch, bring you right to Lake Buff. Then you come through Raceland. Come on down, you got Lake Fields right at the Lockport Boat Launch. Come on down some more, get into La Rose. The parish is building a new boat launch not far from Delta Farms. Come on down some more. You come into Galliano, and before that, you got First Cast up at Basons, brings you right to the Sulphur Mine. Then Catfish Lake and Golden Meadow. Then Leeville, the public boat launch, almost completed now. Then Fouchon. I mean, just great fishing in Lafourche Parish. No reason not for you to own a boat. So here's the businessmen that really make fishing the Leeville area complete and Lafourche Parish. Renovations, takes care of all of my equipment on my boat, everything. Power pole service center, Talon, Minn Kota, Motor Guide, Yamaha, Pathfinder boats, War Eagle boats. I can't say enough about renovations keeping me on the water. Does all my service work. Then you got Gagoo's right there in Golden Meadow. Bait shop right by Catfish Lake. Come on down. Boudreaux's Waterfront Motel. Tie your boat to the bed. I mean, you know, 6 seconds from bed to boat. Then Griffin's right across the street. All my ice, all the ethanol-free fuel. No water in their gas, folks. Like Facebook said. You know, Facebook. Don't get me going on Facebook. But anyway, all the fine businessmen in Lafourche Parish that make your fishing trip complete. Here's the Marina Minute, and I'm going to follow it with the map, and I'm going to show you right where this trench is. Stay tuned. Here's the Marina Minute, followed by the map.
Boudreaux's Waterfront Motel. Dock your boat at the end of the pier right under your room. Set up your grill. Got your own fish cleaning station. Your own ramp. And for big groups, enjoy the sunset at the Boudreaux House.
Boudreaux's
in Leeville.
Griffin's Marina and Ice has bag, block, and blown ice for whatever size boat. Both dockside and roadside ethanol-free fuel, convenience store, breakfast, crispy chicken, all conveniently located in downtown Leeville.
Renovations is your complete marine center for sales, parts, and service. Pathfinder, War Eagle boats, Minn Kota Motor Guide trolling motors, power pole and Minn Kota anchoring systems, pumps, trailer parts. Renovations will keep you on the water. All right, so you can see Philo Bryce Island here, and you can see all of my spots. I've been fishing here all year for specs. We've been featuring Philo Bryce. But again, the important key feature of Philo Bryce, I got a west wind blowing, so I'm in the East Cove, and I'm fishing the trench that used to cut the island in half. The mangroves have grown over it. You don't see it, but it's here, and it's this trench right here that we're catching in. You can see where the boat is positioned. I'm casting out into the deep hole, catching the fish. That's what my guests are doing. So you can see water temperature 80.2, but don't let that fool you. It's been climbing all morning long. Once the sun really gets cooking, that's gonna go up to 90, and that's also the reason why we've got a lot of shark around. They're moving in from the dead zone in the Gulf and coming on up here to the islands now. So I'm not going to go further south and hit islands anymore this season. I'm going to stay north because that's cooler water and it keeps the sharks down to a minimum. So there's the map feature brought to you by the good folks in Lawrence. I know if I show you sonar, let's get over to sonar, enter. You're not going to see much here because I'm in such shallow water.
1.5 feet is where I'm stuck with the power pole, close to the bank, so I'm not marking any fish. They're all further out and towards the front of the boat. So there's the map feature brought to you by the good folks at Lorraine's.
Connie's hooked up to a shark. We're gonna see if we can get one on film for y'all so you can see just what we've been plagued with this time of year. All right, I'll tell you when to check it out. Let's see if he's still there. Didn't cut it. Nope,
no, he's still there.
Still there. Okay, just gonna watch him. He's gonna come up close. But, he's off to the race. It's all right, just stay with him. Stay with him. Taking line. I think you got him hooked right in the corner of the mouth, so he's not gonna cut you. At least that's what I'm hoping. All right, folks, gotta tell you, it's been one heck of a trip with the gang here. Got some nice specs. Connie's got one for the wall. I mean, life's been good. You gotta labor through the sharks this time of year. Water temperature gets up there, you just gotta deal with them. So, let's see what happens. Coming up alongside, I'm watching Connie. Oh, he cut it right there. Thank goodness. So, y'all come on right over here. Folks, check out my anglers. They put a nice mess of fish together. At least Connie did.
Yeah.
And you warned us. You caught that first one and you said, hey, this is what's going to happen. So, and it did.
She smoked me.
Yep, there you go. But that's all right. That's usually what happens when you get a woman on board. We'll see you next week. I got to thank the gang for raising the money to help a young girl that was sick and bought the trip on Between the Banks. This is the last of our three trips that we gave away for this year to film. So, really got to thank you, Wayne. And Connie, great job. Y'all did great fishing out here at Philo Bruce. We'll see you next week with another edition of Between the Banks. In the meantime, good luck fishing. Now, you know what's good about this? We get to stay. They've got to leave.
Uh-huh.
All right. So, we'll see y'all next week.